So I figured out how to get that top cover off and thought it would be a good time to do an engine compartment tour. So as you can see, this one definitely shows its miles with all the dirt and grime and everything. This diesel has a very unique sound hard to describe. It's just like different. Really don't know much about this engine. I do know that's a fuel filter with built-in level sensor. That sucker is expensive. I think it's like $125. So I don't know if this engine has some of the same issues that like the 2005 and 6. CDI does, where you get carbon buildup or soot buildup around the injectors. I do see something interesting going on there. I don't know if I can capture that. I found it that cool. I was trying to show that you can kind of see it there. Looks like there's a little bit of oil down in there. Not too much on the first one. And a little bit more on the second one. I'm actually going to pause this video and splice it together. I'm going to go get my flashlight. Alright, picking up where we left off. Something down in there. But you know, the color of it, you really kind of see it there. And it's blurry. So the color of it, to me, almost indicates that somebody just spilled some oil when they were refilling it, because diesel oil turns black pretty much immediately after you change the oil. And so I actually don't think that's anything to worry about. I'm gonna pop the flashlight on again and what I can tell, there's really no carbon around the injectors. No soot around the injectors, so that's a good thing. We got some kind of a control unit over there. let the top cover slide into. And I believe there may be a couple other pegs down on. That one there is what it's screwed into. So it looks like we've got some sort of idler pulley or something there. Down below there looks like we've got our AC compressor. That down there may be the DPF, I'm not sure. Pulling lines down there. Big cover on the front of the engine, you can't really see a whole lot. Try to get underneath it and see if we've got anything leaking. I don't smell any oil burning or anything like that. I smell a slight little bit of diesel exhaust fumes. Here we got the ABS unit, AC connector, brake fluid. The dealer I bought this from used that gunk on it to shine up the compartment. I hate that. Now you can kind of get a glimpse of the turbo down there. I don't smell anything leaking down there. Different story on my BMW. Those of you who have seen the video I made when I hung my phone down into the engine compartment of the BMW, it was kind of a mess. So anyway, this is the quick tour of the engine compartment of a 2014 Mercedes Benz GLK250.